like, well, I will say this, I'm not being pressed by nobody. Everybody in my family know how I am. I'm very private, and yet for me to come out and speak or say anything, like I said, that's my private page. I have a right to say on my page what I want to say. But for anyone to take that material and go and put it public to an audience for pay, I guess that just come with the territory. You know, no harm, no foul. To me, even though I don't like it, this is the day and age that we live in, and I have to accept it. You know, everything is not always going to be good. Is it any good in social media? I'll let you determine that. I guess with the notoriety and the fame that my brother got, I'm hearing a lot of people really was really consume most of their day watching some of his videos and just living vicariously through his experiences and his comedy and all those things. And you know, to me, that's a form of entertainment. And I mean, this is just one of the many wonderful gifts my brother has. But to include me as if I'm trying to do something malicious, I mean, you don't understand me. You know, as far as the situation that me and my brother had a long time ago, that's a long time ago. We got through that. And although it took some time, last time we went out and enjoyed ourselves, I mean, this is telling, it was on the 6th of June. And I had a good time with my brother. And we went fishing, actually. And I was supposed to be fishing with him the day of the accident. And I say that to say this. My grandfather told me a long time ago, there is so much good in the worst of us, and so much bad in the best of us, that it scarcely behooves any of us to talk about the rest of us. Look up to one, down on none, and look straight across and you'll see yourself. And this is what I live by. Now, in life, situations happen, things are said, and obviously there's an emotional response. Sometimes, you know, I've learned over the years that everything is not going to always be good, but you have to accept everything that comes with whatever environment you put yourself in or whatever situation you put yourself in. I just want to say I'm not profiting off my brother if I take 1 cent. 1 cent. Now, I know a lot of people go come in here and they probably screenshotting this and sending this to other platforms and things of that nature. That's okay with me. And you know, it's okay with me because nothing I'm saying is something that I wouldn't say for profit, for gain, or anything like that. I just said if I take 1 cent, may my soul go to hell. I'm really affected by this situation with my brother. There is a lot of systematic things going on I have no knowledge of. I'm not going to partake in any of these events to try to garner a fan base or anything like that. I don't know any of these people. And after today, I'm not going to speak on this situation again. I know my brother's life and his situation was special to a lot of people, and there are sincere people out there and that really care about him and was really concerned about him. So I'm doing this for, number one, I did it for my family and the friends that's close to the family. If you notice on my, if you went to my Instagram, which that's the only platform that I correspond with anyone via social media. I don't have no TikTok, no Twitter. I don't have no Facebook. I don't have none of that. You know, I'm totally opposite of my brother when it comes in respects to that. I don't do this for entertainment or to get anything from anyone as far as monetary compensation. And that's just not the way I get down. You know, I'm an honorable man. I'm married. I love my children. I love my family, no matter the differences. And I'm not ashamed to come and say what I got to say, if it's in good faith and it's honest. Other than that, I won't say nothing. Now, as far as your enemies, you know, it's a wise saying, you know, that where darkness is, crimes will be committed. But it's not merely he who commits the crime that is at fault, but rather he who created the darkness. And obviously, there's a lot of darkness in this situation, but you have to accept that. That's what comes with being in this environment. You know, I can't knock these people for doing what they do on a daily basis. I'm not going to say that you're wrong or right. I'm just saying, hey, if you're a respectful person, you do respectful things. If you're a disrespectful person, you go do disrespectful things. You know, and respect is earned. It's not given. I'm not expecting that anybody is going to give me something that I didn't earn. You know, obviously, there's a lot of narratives out there that's not true. And one of them is that I'm being pressed by family or being pressed by anybody. If you know me, I don't care about pressure. You know, I've been dealing with pressure all my life. I'm not a person who folds in pressure. I'm a person who loves hard, who's loyal, honorable. And even when I spent my time with my brother, I was happy to be with my brother. On June 6th, I was happy to spend time with my brother, and we went fishing, actually. We had a good time. I look at the video of him coming to my house, and it just really hurt me. You know, a lot of people have said worse things even before this situation. There's been a lot of things that people have said, and I feel like anything short of death is an opportunity for us to grow and to learn from our experiences. And none of us is perfect. Of course, he made mistakes too. He may have said things, and I've heard that being said numerous times. And, you know, of course, I feel bad for a lot of things that was said. There was a lot of things said about me that wasn't true. And, you know, but I know what happened. I don't understand it, you know. So when you deal with things based on understanding and not just, you know, just being reactionary to things, you'll be wise enough to choose to avoid certain situations. So, you know, to God be the glory in this situation. To everybody that's being sincere, that's loving, that's family and friends, true family and friends, I commend you and I hold you in high esteem. All the good things that's been said about him, I'm very proud of that. I'm also equally, I'm not gonna say I'm shocked by some of the reactions of some of the other people who have said some real bad things. But I mean, that just come with the territory, you know. That's life. We can't expect the good without the bad, you know. And somebody even said, was the glasses I was wearing his? Like, dude, I haven't seen my brother in some time. You know, I take good care of myself and my family. You know, I'm a family man. Everybody think godliness is gain. The Bible will tell you, you got a corrupt mind if you believe that. Godliness is knowing what you did wrong, knowing how you violated. You know, I take good care of myself and my family. You know, I'm a family man, you know. And I take care of myself. I don't need any help or support from anyone. If I was, I'd be over here reckless like I see a lot of other people doing that's trying to, you know, get something off his name or get some kind of monetary gain from, you know, this situation, you know. God bless you. That's all I got to say. And we think blessings is material, and that's foolishness, because everybody think godliness is gain. The Bible will tell you, you got a corrupt mind if you believe that. Godliness is knowing what you did wrong, knowing how you violated God's law, and making an adjustment. That's what a blessing is. It's not getting a new car, you can lose it. It's not getting a new a wife, a husband, a house, a dog, none of that stuff. That's material gain. That's gain. You know, gain, that's foolishness to think godliness is gain. That's in the Bible. Look it up. I think I'm gonna make my video public. I had a lot of people that was messaging me, and as many people that messaged me, whether good or bad, I had nothing bad to say to none of them. You know, just think of this. If it wasn't for the people who killed Jesus, none of us would be saved. You had to have a Judas. Nobody else was gonna do that work, you know? And he fed his enemies, you know? He gave him the power to subdue demons. And at the end, he was betrayed by his own kind. One who walked with him throughout the 3-year period of his ministry. So who am I? Who is Keith? We just men. Yeah, some are more known than others, but we all men. We all capable of being praised. We all capable of being despised and hated on. There's no problem with it. It comes with the territory. That's part of being a man, you know. And you'll know, like Martin Luther King said, you'll know a man through times of adversity and conflict, you know, and what you go see in me is strength. You ain't gonna see no hate from me. I'm not getting on here hating nobody or saying you wrong for trying to, do malicious things that come with the territory. We have to accept it both ways. So I'm gonna make my page open. I didn't want to take that long on this video, but I just wanted to let y'all know that God hears, you know, God sees, and whatever there's just weights and balances for everything that's done, whether good or bad. And if you can live with the consequences of your decisions and the bad that you're doing, understand, you know, these things can happen to you as well. Everything that you're doing, God is weighing that, and his scales always gonna come out balanced. You know, whether you're doing it for good or for evil, you're going to get a just weight with the Most High. So, with that being said, I'm gonna continue with my day. I'm gonna continue with my life. Like I said, I want everybody to pray for my brother. You don't have to if you don't want to. You can hate if you want to. That don't stop God from doing what he gonna do. It never did. It's not gonna stop me from doing what I do. I'm not being censored by nobody. Nobody, contrary to popular belief, I'm not pressured by anyone. I don't care what you have to say, whether good or bad. I'm not gonna say anything. God bless you, because it's different when the rabbit got the gun now. That rabbit hole go deep. So this is the last time I'm going to talk about this. I'm not going to address this anymore. I'm going to move on with my life. And I hope you be blessed in your life. And I'm praying for a speedy recovery for my brother. And for the well-being of his children during this time. And my family, who I've talked to several times over for the past couple of weeks, you know. So, and then notice also, I hadn't come out and said anything until yesterday. In fact, another thing, I didn't even see the video of the accident until yesterday. My wife showed it to me. I didn't want to even see it. I had no idea that even existed until yesterday. Well, I ain't gonna say that I didn't know it existed, but I didn't want to see it until yesterday. And that was by default because my wife had it on her video, and she I seen it, and you know, it last night just couldn't sleep. Had a